Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum. Peace be with all of you. Today, maybe today is the best day during Nelson Mandela's commemorative day to share with you mainly the PDL who are right in front of us. Of course, the dignitaries from the overseas countries, government, national officials, and of course, with the compassionate and ever determined lawyer, leader of this facility, General Greg Katapang. Last August 8th, 1983, I brought out to the president of our country, the most passionate and committed leader for national unity, and proposal to have inked the Remedial Executive Clemency. I told him, Mr. President, in the past, even when I was at UP, University of Studies, until I became a professional and a leader in Mindanao, I only hear of the president and the nation from then on to announce the freedom of our brothers and sisters throughout the country during Christmas. So I told him, I visited with the executive secretary, former Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, Lucas Bersamin, and brought this idea to him initially. And he said, go, he always calls me, go. This is a good idea, why don't you see Secretary Boying Remulla? And I thank him for that, and immediately I went out of his room, and with Allah's assistance, there was at the lobby holding a phone, talking over the phone, Boying Remulla. I didn't have to go anymore to the Department of Justice. He was right then, there, you know, possibly waiting for me without his knowing it. So I talked to him, the boy in Romulia. I told him that I just came from the executive secretary's office and he requested, advised me to talk to you about this idea, this proposal. And instantaneously, boy, it's my friend from way back in the days, told me, go, that's Nobel. I said, that's why I'm here. No Muslim leader has ever come to see me about this. I said, that's why I'm here in front of you. So immediately called these two other secretaries, Jojo Cadiz and Leo Marco is with us now, to work this out with me, and then put in all the legal provisions for this Ramadan executive clemency. And after that, I requested Jojo Cadiz to arrange my meeting with the Board of Pardons and Parole, which he did, and I went before the Fifth Amendment Committee and took up this issue and proposal. Thereafter, I requested the DOJ Secretary's Office to arrange my meeting and visit for the first time to the Bureau of Corrections. And here, I found a very compassionate military man who understands more than many of us how it's it to be in a confined situation, deprived of liberty. This started my friendship with this great leader here, this facility, Greg Katapa. And let us give him a good round of applause for that appreciation of him. Having said that, now every Ramadan, and also for our Christian brethren, because we have Christmas, we will now be having regularly attending to persons deprived of liberty, especially those who have reached advanced age, and those who are very sick, and those who have already, met the required sentence. Many, I think some of them are still around, and we have to look into this. That's why we are now organizing a corps of Muslim lawyers to look into this and to assist the good general, the secretary, the director general of this facility. For the first time, I want to thank these institutions of government without any negative reaction, without opposition, all in support of this Ramadan executive clemency for and in behalf of our Muslim brothers and sisters who are not here, numbering more than 10 million, the biggest minority in this country. Thank you and good day to all of you.